अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन। तो यार PMTS का जो सीज़न 4 है वो आ गया है। इनका जो टूर्नामेंट है वो स्क्वाड के अंदर होता है और इनकी एंट्री फीस भी जो है वो बहुत कम होती है और स्लॉट्स भी जो हैं वो बहुत ये कम रखते हैं। तो आप इनका टूर्नामेंट जो है वो खेल सकते हैं। व्हाट्सएप नंबर भी दिया हुआ है। बहुत ही कमाल की मैनेजमेंट होती है इनकी। तो आप लाजमी इस टूर्नामेंट में खेल के प्राइज़ जीत सकते हैं। अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन। तो यार आज आप सबके लिए PMCO Match 1 की जो है वो हाईलाइट्स लेके आए हैं। इसमें जो टीम प्रीडेटर है यानी कि टीम फाइम, उन्होंने जो है वो बहुत ही अच्छी किल्स के साथ जो है वो चिकन डिनर की है। तो लाजमी जो है वो पूरी हाईलाइट्स आपने देखनी है। एंड इस जो ये ग्रुप है इनका, इसके अंदर जो है वो एक वो हैकर टीम भी है जो मतलब हैक करके क्वालिफाई हुई है, जिसका नाम आप सबको पता भी होगा, TS टीम स्टोनर्स जिनका नाम है। बस यही रिक्वेस्ट है यार, वीडियो को पूरा देखिएगा और जाते जाते चैनल को भी सब्सक्राइब कर देना।
As well, M4 6 times a really trusted weapon takes down one. Wow, what a play! Again, I'm in the compound working in their favor. C4 out in the open trying to work with the smoke, but how long are you going to be able to just keep that smoke wall? Again, you will need to find some cover. You are going to have to rush and push because the circle is gunning for you. But C4 seems to be out in the open, Whoa. And this is not going to be good for them. With that, of course, Whoa. Another knock coming in from the side of 2X, and this is just detrimental for C4, is losing one after the other. All members of their clan. As you can see right now, the circle is just with one team. Rest, every team has to get inside the circle. That's going to be a bad luck for the other teams, as they'll have to move in the open. And that again changes a lot of things for the teams right now. You can see onto the other side, with the blue zone will be causing a lot of damage. And there are a lot of teams onto the minimap. As you can see, six teams to be precise are just out here. You can see TUF, you can see Frost, you can see RTN. And then there are other teams as well. 47 onto the other side as well. So Fime. All right, well, Fime Morte is looking really good as he's on a domination with those three kills, but KOD gets eliminated meanwhile.
Well, Retribution right here. Bolin from Retribution is not in a good spot because, again, the information has already been given and he's kind of in a sandwich situation over there, which, of course, it's only a matter of time with not enough health remaining, not his team members being able to support him. He is probably going to get knocked out of that situation. We'll have to find out as to how exactly does Retribution bring this into their control. But right here, of course, we are looking at that smoke wall exactly, and how will they be able to push along with side this? Well, let's see.
This is going to be a difficult one, but look at this. Klaus takes down Ghazi Khan. Team Ghazi gets eliminated onto the other side, and well, Hassan has spotted one more, and Venom goes down. All right, that was a good spray. That was a good spray. Just moving up forward, and all right, that's a ram up. That's a ram up happening from Abdullah, but he will go down. He won't be living long to tell that tale onto the other side. Team TUF gets eliminated. Six teams are surviving, and look at this. Berlin's down again. He needs to be picked up if you want to go for that money heist that is on your shoulders, but no, Hassan, he's burning, he goes down as well. Martin, the last man surviving, but for how long? He stands up as well to take down Klaus, and he does the job.
Wow, Retribution bringing in perfect control and taking out Frost. Klaus out of into the lobby, and that is incredible. And with that, team Frost is out. And Fime right here taking another shot towards Retribution, where indeed he did stand up as we just witnessed, and that has given information down towards Fime Ahmed, and he knows where to expect Retribution to come in from. And with that, C4, two man still alive, still holding behind that, and well, slowly and steadily it seems like that smoke wall has worked in their favor, and they have some control and some information as to how exactly are they going to be able to push up on top of this mountain. Is going to be a difficult approach, because Fime, as soon as they get the information, they will have the upper hand.
Fime Esports 47, 2X official NSC, C4 Gaming, Team Retribution. These are the teams surviving out here, but someone's gonna burn, someone is burning. Once again, the Molotov's being put to the best use as it can be. Alright, Ghost takes down one as well. Pharaoh does the job, and they might as well just go for the elimination. The players are going down slowly and steadily. If you have another throwable, just use it, because you can get the kills, and they actually get the kills this time. 2X official NSC gets eliminated on the 5th position. 47, they have 6 kills and they are looking really good. C4, I mean, Ahmed needs to go for that revive, but this is a trick situation. This is something. You have an oasis of a chicken dinner right next to you, or you can go for the revive, but look at this. Fime, Ahmed and Hardy go down with that blast.
How could Fime not see this? Of course, they were standing right next to a well, a vehicle that had not exploded, and they were trying to use that as a cover, which is of course not going to be able to work towards your favor. But with that, of course, we're looking at Team 47, Pharaoh, who has been knocking players left, right, and center. Another knock coming in from him, and there's no helmet though. There's no helmet in his favor, but he does have the support of the house.
He does, but no helmet can be tricky. All right, well, Pharaoh goes down out here. Now his vest is also completely damaged. Almost just on the verge of being taken down. But, well, Retribution gets eliminated. Down to top three teams right now, ladies and gentlemen. You can see 47, 5, and C4 Gaming. C4 have two players for themselves. Again, still surviving. 5, they have three players, but Predator needs up a revive. 47, they have two players surviving. 2 need up a revive. That's going to be a tricky situation for them. 47, they have 7 kills. 5, 6, and C4 Gaming have 4 kills. Akim, all right, they want to move forward. They know what they can go for this one, but next he takes on Akim. C4, they have one player surviving, but for how long can he survive? It's Sam onto the other side. Fime onto the other side is taking a fight against 47. 47 gets eliminated. Fime, this can be your game. Ahmed has to go for a revive against Morte. That's what he's doing. C4, last player surviving, Ahmed is also surviving out there. This might be a tricky situation. Both the players, revives are coming up. It's gonna be a 2v2. Morte gets up a revive, putting up a first aid out here, but onto the other side, Ahmed and Akiba still out there. Ahmed from Fime revives his own teammate. Ahmed from C4 revives his own teammate.
Wow, what a massive play. What a massive, phenomenal play this is turning out to be. I mean, again, though, C4 has the information. So does Fime. The only possibility right here is going to be, well, how exactly is C4 going to be trying to push along? Because again, Fime has that upper hill advantage. Wow. And with that, of course, smoke's being brought in once again. And C4, well, a cub is slowly moving on along towards Ahmed and Morte from Fime. And Fime does seem to be in a pretty good spot, because right here, if you look towards C4, well, he only has the cover of a tree, but perfect grenades coming in one after the other. And with that, Fime separating themselves, bringing in a bit more of a funnel approach, bringing in that much more of a squad approach, where they're going to be separating and bringing in a cross. But again, keep in mind, C4 has another player who is in the back, and that is Ahmed.
45 seconds, and then the last circle is going to be just moving up forward. That's an important one for both the teams. Morte is at a good off angle. I mean, all the stuff Ahmed will be doing from Fime, and Morte might just be going for a back shot. But look at Ahmed from C4. He's also onto the other side as well. Morte takes down one. C4, Ahmed is the last one surviving. He's got location also compromised. Look at Morte. He's just telling all the location areas as he knows that where the opponent is. Ahmed, he's taking up a fight against him. All right, making it a 1v1 once again. This is the first match, and it's already chaotic with the players. Ahmed versus Ahmed again. The story continues. Fime versus C4. Revive comes in once again. Ahmed, he cannot revive his teammate. He has to move up forward, but an Uzi might just do the job. One bullet will do the damage. The rest will do the job. The revival is going out there, but will the revival continue? It does not. And Fime, oh my god. Oh my god. Brilliant gameplay coming up from Fime as well as C4.
Absolute dominating circle that was, and the way these two lads played, I mean, all four of them, they were just phenomenal. They were just in control.